chess. Then my father has arranged for me to marry a princess. Her name is Lily Lalalolakins, and she's the ugliest dog I've ever seen. Pop never did care much for my feelings. He's just worried about his political dealings. So while our kingdom will unite with hers, I'll be hanging out with bums down in the sewers. Or I'll dwell in the tombs and build a newspaper nest where I can completely avoid the princess. I know it sounds mean, but this marriage is wrong for both her and me. It's not based on love at all, we're just being played like we're pawns. It's not fair, no it's not fair, but I don't think either of our fathers care. I think it's high time that these arranged marriages stop. Stop! I'm getting so frustrated, I think my head's gonna pop. Pop! Well, this is my life, I can pick my own wife, it's not for them to choose. I'm gonna run away, it's time to lace up my royal running shoes. Goodbye. I waited till night and as the castle slept, I slowly got out of my bed. Took off my bonny slippers and put on my shoes. Hung a rope from my window, climbed down, and then started on my way to a new life. Into the wild, smiling in the moonlight. So excited it was like a wondrous dream, until a bandit jumped down in front of me.
Surrender your gold or I'll be forced to chop you down.
I laughed at his threat and said, you better leave now.
I'm afraid you're confused, I'm the one with a sword,
but I'm the one with this crossbow, don't say you weren't warned. And as I finished my words, I aimed my weapon at him. He jumped straight in the air and ran far away from me. So I continued along, I was feeling quite proud, until I saw a cute gal getting robbed by a clown.
Hey!
Without hesitation, yeah, I punched him over a cliff.
See ya!
Then the damsel in distress rewarded me with a kiss. I asked her why in the world she was out here all alone at night. She said she was running away from her chains, from a dead-end life.
Aww.
What a coincidence. So and me, I said. So we walked, yawned and talked, and became good friends. And when morning's first light came dawning on us, we came upon an old hut way out in the woods.
By the looks of the place, nobody had lived there for a long while, so we figured there'd be no harm in us resting there before traveling on. I sat outside to keep watch, just in case an evil troll came sniffing around or something.
But soon I drifted off to sleep. I was exhausted from the long walk, though my eyes didn't remain shut long. I heard a scream come from inside the hut. I rushed in and saw an evil troll. He had frightened my friend half to death. She sat with her back to the wall. Her eyes were wide, the poor girl was shaking. I tackled that troll with all my heat, and then I wailed him with a 2x4. He tried to make a break for it, but I tackled him back to the floor. I guess he wasn't hungry for a beating. He didn't like the knuckle sandwich I was feeding to his face nonstop, a full force. And when I felt he finally had enough, once he got what he deserved, I picked him up and booted him right out the door. Yeah! When I was said and done, I got rewarded with another kiss. And in time, the lady